I feel the sun going down. How will you feel when I'm no longer around? You took the smile from my face. With this life you take, your deeds can never be erased. My eyes are innocence, and the truth will set me free. If not from these prison bars, then God will rest me in his arms. And my liberty, no longer bound to lock and key. God, we trust in your good name. I have no fear to blame. I long to see the sun upon my face. I want to hold you close once more and feel your warm embrace. Why won't the light shine through the clouds? I wish to shred these threads and hold your hand to homeward bound. My eyes are innocent.
It was 1997. Van Treese was the owner of the Best Budget Inn in Oklahoma City. The motel handyman bludgeoned him to death while he slept in room 102. The state first arrested the young handyman, Justin Sneed, and then went after Glossop, alleging a case of murder for hire. This is a never-before-seen videotaped interrogation of the confessed killer, Justin Sneed.
I don't think it's just you. I think there are more people involved, and you can straighten out a lot of things, and I just don't think you should take the whole thing.
Sneed was the state's star witness and really the only proof Glossop was involved at all. Both sides agreed, no question. Richard Glossop wasn't even in the room when Barry Van Treese was murdered. Prosecutors said in court, hiring out the murder was worse, paying for a man's death without even having to bother to carry it out.
If it's at all your idea, the whole thing?
No, sir.
Well, okay, tell me.
You need to tell us about it.
Justin Sneed was spared his life. He got a life sentence in exchange for his testimony against Richard Glossop.
I feel the sun going down. How will you feel when I'm no longer around? You took the smile from my face. With this life you take, your deeds can never be erased. My eyes are innocence, and the truth will set me free. If not from these prison bars, then God will rest me in his arms. And my liberty, no longer bound to lock and key. God, we trust in your good name. I have no fear, I'm not to blame. I long to see the sun upon my face.
Fox 25 has been working to investigate the claims of Richard Glossop's supporters that information available now was not given to the first two juries. We were able to contact some of those jury members, and we're protecting the identity of one who asked us to share a statement.
Governor Fallon has no reason to second guess, again, either the jurors or the courts, and so the execution will go forward.
The governor's office has repeatedly said they are supporting the jurors who decided Richard Glossop's fate. The office has also said they are upholding the will of 24 jurors in two separate trials, despite that first trial being declared unconstitutional. Now, one of the original jurors is speaking out. In a statement to Fox 25, the juror writes, based on the evidence presented at that trial, they would reach the same verdict, and that they reached that decision based on careful consideration of the evidence. However, after learning of the new evidence in the form of police reports and videotaped confessions, that juror is upset by what the jury never heard. Quote, if the defense would have presented me the case that they are presenting now in the original trial, I would not have given a guilty verdict. The juror goes on to say, I think that now there is enough question/evidence out there that there may be another story than what we, the jurors, were given. The juror adds, I feel that this situation needs to be looked at and at the very least given a 60-day stay to make for certain that all the stones are unturned and everything is looked at with a fine-tooth comb. The juror issued a plea that their opinion be taken into consideration regarding the impending execution. Fox 25 reached out to the governor's office for a comment a day after that office made claims they were supporting all of the 24 jurors. But now the office says that that first trial was unfair and they will not be considering any opinions of the first jurors. Spokesman Alex Wentz emailed Fox 25 saying, "This juror served in Glossop's first trial, which was thrown out by a court. The fact that Glossop had one conviction overturned and was given a second trial illustrates that our justice system does respond to mistakes and has treated Glossop fairly. Governor Fallon believes in our justice system and is committed to upholding the law."
Up front at 9:30 tonight, did the state mislead the jurors who sentenced Richard Glossop to death?
Fox 25's Phil Cross has been investigating claims by Glossop supporters when he uncovered testimony by a state official that raises new questions about how fair the trial really was. It's a story you'll see only on Fox.
The year was 2011. Governor Mary Fallon had just taken the reins of Oklahoma and inherited a problem, a medical examiner's office rife with controversy.
To say that it was a train wreck is probably being kind.
Attorney Jay Mindros fought for reform of the ME's office after allegations of inaccurate reports, inconsistent testimony, and accusations of criminal misconduct. Governor Fallon signed into law the Reform Act, which allowed families a chance to go to court to correct errors in findings by the state pathologists.
It's time to get this agency in a position that it's functioning.
However, when asked by Fox 25 Now, the governor's office says that bill was actually about improving operations at the ME's office. And the governor has never questioned any rulings by that agency, even before she was governor.
If there is any question at all that hinges on the reliability of the medical examiner's office from this time period, I would say there should be a significant doubt as to the accuracy and reliability.
It turns out there is such a case. Richard Glossop, who's scheduled to die in less than a week. Fox 25 contacted jurors from Glossop's second trial who said the key factor in determining his guilt was testimony from the state pathologist. That pathologist testified Barry Van Treese slowly bled to death and could have potentially been saved if Glossop had told police Justin Sneed had confessed a murder to him. However, no one on Glossop's defense team objected or questioned that pathologist as to why that testimony was different from the first trial and a direct contradiction of the official autopsy report, which lists the cause of death as blunt trauma.
There should never be a discrepancy between an autopsy report and what a medical examiner testifies to in court.
Fox 25 presented our findings to Glossop's new attorneys for a reaction, but even they had not had a chance to review that aspect of the trial. His attorney said our questions raised a serious enough issue. They had an independent pathologist review the documents, testimonies, and pictures from the case. The forensic pathologist reported the trial testimony was in fact scientifically inaccurate. So while jurors were told Glossop could have saved Van Treese's life the morning following the attack, the medical evidence shows Van Treese died within minutes of Sneed's violent assault. These facts were also not mentioned in the appeal to the trial. Not surprising to Mindros, who says outside experts are difficult for public defender offices to afford. And the problems with the medical examiner's office were not widely known until years after Glossop's appeal had already been denied.
The Oklahoma Death Chamber has a fresh coat of paint now, an updated protocol, and a to-do list 49 inmates long. A few doors down, Glossop, steadfastly declaring his innocence, says they pinned this crime on the wrong man.
Has there ever been a time that you have admitted your guilt in this case?
I don't have no guilt in this case. After the fact, I made some really stupid decisions. I'm not saying I didn't. But if stupid's a crime, I'm guilty of being stupid, but I've sure paid my price for that.
Some wonder if his moral compass is significantly crooked enough to die for this crime.
The dying part don't bother me. Everybody dies. But I want people to know that I didn't kill this man. I didn't participate, I didn't plan or anything to do with this crime.
I feel the sun going down. How will you feel when I'm no longer around? You took the smile from my face. With this life you take, your deeds can never be erased. My eyes are innocence, and the truth will set me free. If not from these prison bars, then God will rest me in his arms. And my liberty, no longer bound to lock and key. God, we trust in your good name. I have no fear, I'm not to blame. I long to see the sun upon my face. I want to hold you close once more and feel your warm embrace. Why won't the light shine through the clouds? I wish to shred these threads and hold your hand to homeward bound. My eyes are innocence, and the truth will set me free. If not from these prison bars, then God will rest me in your arms. And my liberty, no longer bound to lock and key. God, we trust in your good name. I have no fear, I'm not to blame.